In this video, we will review and give tips on navigating Sakai as a student. Sakai is UNC's centrally supported learning management system, so think of this as the central location for all of your course content online. If you're looking for your class syllabus, need to contact your professor, submit a paper or quiz, Sakai is likely where you will do that. Instructors at Carolina are not required to use Sakai, so you will first want to verify whether you will actually be using Sakai for each of your classes. So to get started, open Firefox, which is the recommended browser for Sakai, and go to sakai.unc.edu. Click the Onion login button in the top right corner and log in with your Onion and password. Once you're in Sakai, you will be taken to your private home workspace. So let's first orient ourselves to the system. Towards the top of your screen, you will see your top favorite tabs for Sakai sites that you are a member of. You can also click on the Sites button in the top right corner to access other Sakai sites and to modify your favorite sites. So if you want a site to appear in your top tabs, simply click on the star to light it and then it will appear at the top for you. You can click on the Organize Favorites tab to organize how you want your favorite tabs to be listed. So just click on the little hamburger icon for a site and then reposition it where you want it to be located. Once you close out of that, your changes will automatically save and you will see your updates. If you are not seeing a course site, that could be for a number of reasons. Your instructor has either not created a Sakai site for it yet, they may not have published a site to give students access, or they may just not be using Sakai at all. You'll notice in the top right corner that I have a photo uploaded for this Sakai account. And this is particularly helpful if you want your picture to be appearing in all of your Sakai sites. So for example, if your instructor is using discussion forums, it's helpful for everyone to see each other's photos to quickly identify who everyone is. So if you want to upload a picture to your account, click on either the blank avatar or the existing photo if you have uploaded one. Click on the photo again to change it. Click on Browse. Select your photo and open it, and then click on Save. To navigate to a course site, click on the course ID in your top tabs, and then you will be taken to the site. So one of the first things you will probably look for is your course syllabus, and you will find that in either the syllabus tool, or you can check in the resources. And this is also where you will find any other files that your instructor has shared with you. Some instructors may also be using the lessons tool, which is a place for your instructor to basically add all of your course content in one place. So this is another place to check. Now let's take a look at the communication tools. So if you need to send an email to your professors, or if you need to message the entire class, you can do that in the messages tool. Click on the Compose Message tab. Select your recipients. Enter the subject, message, you can upload an attachment, and then click on Send. You'll notice when I click on the Messages tool, this will reset the tool that I'm in. You can also check the Received folder to see any messages that have been sent to you. Your instructor may also be using the Announcements tool, so this is another place to check for any communications from your instructor. If you need to submit any papers or other written work, that will be done in the Assignments tool. All you have to do is click on the name of the assignment, enter any written text, or you can upload a file and then click on Submit. Once it has been successfully submitted, you should receive an email confirmation. You can also go back to the main assignments page and then see any feedback your instructors may have shared with you on an assignment. Now let's take a look at submitting online tests and quizzes. So before we take a specific look at that, it's extremely important to note that you should only keep one browser tab open of Sakai while taking tests. Because of how Sakai saves your answers, opening multiple browser tabs can cause problems with your answers being saved correctly. It's imperative that you stay within one browser tab of Sakai before you begin a test and while you are taking a test, so that you don't accidentally lose any answers while you're taking a test. And you can see that message here written within the tests and quizzes tool. If you must navigate to another part of Sakai, save and exit your test before navigating away. Then go back and make sure your answers were saved before continuing in the test. So to begin a test, you want to look in the Take an Assessment section and click on the name of the test. You can review any instructions here, check the honor pledge if that has been enabled by your instructor, and click on Begin Assessment. If your test is timed, you will see the timer at the top to let you know how much time is remaining before you must submit this. Go through and answer all of the questions. And then at the very bottom of the page, you will either save your answers manually, or Sakai also saves the answers automatically every 5 minutes, and then continue on to the next page. Then the last step is to submit for grading. And once that has successfully submitted, you will receive an email confirmation. If your instructor has selected to share feedback with you, you will see that listed at the bottom of the test and quizzes tool. If your instructor is using discussion boards, you will find that in the forms tool. Click on the name of a topic and then select view full description for any instructions that your instructor has given you. To start a new thread, click on start a new conversation. Enter the title, the message, you can upload an attachment, and then click on post. To quickly see all the messages that have been posted to this particular discussion board, click on display message content here at the top. And then you can easily see all the messages that have been posted by everyone in this topic. I also recommend clicking to mark all as read. One last thing to review is the gradebook. So if your instructor has shared any grades and feedback comments with you, this is where you can see that. If you have any questions with Sakai, you can review the Sakai tutorials by clicking the tutorials icon on the Sakai homepage, and then review the help guides. You can also go to help.unc.edu to submit an online help request or chat with an analyst from the ITS service desk, or call 919-962-HELP. Let us know how we can help you, and we'll be glad to assist you.